Hi lovers, Coach Kara here. So today we're actually doing a requested video from one of our fellow love bugs who reached out to me regarding a particular matter, and that being co-parenting issues with the ex, of course. So that's what we're talking about today. And if any of you have a video that you like to request, you know, so everybody isn't capable of, you know, affording our services. Even though if you are subscribed, you will receive a 50% discount on any services. So yeah, there's that. So today I want to talk about, it's challenging to co-parent with my baby mother or father, and what should I do? So listen, of course, everyone has their own unique situation going on when it comes to parenting, because if you're not together and residing together, it could be quite challenging, depending on the people who are involved. So listen, I'm going to give you a couple of scenarios just to give you some, you know, sort of, you know, basis to go off of, okay? So of course, there's always going to be that one parent who does not want to comply with certain rules or just certain things that you have set in place, especially if you are the parent who has basically sole custody. You know, you may have your child's father or mother who just wants to stop by anytime at their own convenience, unannounced, and it causes issues. And they're just doing, they may be the type of parent who just want to be a complete thorn in your side just because, you know. More than likely, you two may have had a very bad breakup, and it just kind of like just transitioned into parenting, you know, which is ultimately going to fall into bad parenting, an unhealthy situation and environment for the child or children. And so they may want to stop by anytime or just become, you know, a nuisance, especially if you are involved and now you're living with that new person. You know, when it comes to parenting, okay, everything has to be planned pretty much, right? And so that could be quite concerning for you, especially when you know if you don't have the best temperament or maybe your partner or whomever, it can become escalated at any time. So here is my advice to that. And this is just one little thing that you probably should try if you haven't done so already. Just so both of you can be on a schedule, I would suggest, and I know you may not like this, is just going to the court and see if they can make arrangements, that sort of thing. So both of you will have boundaries set and placed and an arranged schedule, okay, of which both of you have to abide by. Now, granted, if someone who does not comply, well, then of course there are consequences to that. There may be a situation to where you feel like, look, my child or children's father or mother isn't the best example. I don't want them around them. Perhaps they are a functioning addict of some sort of substance. And you may not want that kind of vibe and energy around him. And I get that. I get it. But here's the thing. Children don't understand that. They are innocent minded. So if you tell them that, well, mom and dad, they're not in the best state, or more than likely, most people don't say it like that. Well, your dad, he's a crack addict, he's a crackhead, you know. You're not going to give it the best example. Most people don't, but you probably should. And because of that, I really feel like no one should be deprived from wanting to be a parent, of wanting to be a part of their child or children's lives, regardless of their status. You know, they should have some sort of interaction and interpersonal relationship, because it is necessary for the child. So what I would suggest is doing like conjugal visits. Is that the proper term? Or is that related to prison? Anyways, you know what I'm saying? Like, be with them in their presence. I know you may not want them in a home, totally understandable. Not a lot of places to go to right now because it's 40 degrees, at least in most places. I would suggest going to a mall, meeting someplace open where they can spend some quality time with that parent. It has to be done because they're going to need to have some kind of bond with that parent, regardless of what their status is, as far as being mentally and physically stable. You know, they're going to need that. Now, here is the more prevalent and prominent drama when it comes to parenting. So you're going to have that one situation to where you probably are still, you two were sleeping around at one point after you broke up, and then someone decided to get into a relationship, and then someone decided to put that person on child support. And then everything goes crazy and is dramatic and toxic for everyone involved. So ironically, the other day I was on IG and I'm going through my feed and this video pops up. I think it came out like last year sometime, where the girl was walking behind the guy bragging about how she's going to get $1,200 a week and you're not going to see your kids anymore and yada, yada, yada. I'll probably post a video so you can actually see it.
Where you going? Where you going? $1,200 a week now. It's over. Yep. You wanted to take care of that girl, your little new girlfriend, and her kids. Now, yes. Because you got me messed up. You got me messed up. I don't care. You taking care of other people's kids.
You getting $1,200 a week for what?
Yes. Because I need all that money. I need it all. I need every penny I can get. Yep. Now you can see your kids once a week instead of seeing them all the time.
So whenever you feel like it. Once a week to every day.
Oh well. Oh, at least I'm getting paid. Did you want to be laid up with some other girl? Yeah. You got me messed up. Now.
You stop doing that. No.
Because that's what you get. You embarrass me. You embarrass me. You embarrass me. You embarrassing me. I don't care. They can look all they want. Oh well.
I can't believe you, dog.
Oh well. Now. Yeah, $1,200 a week. Yep. No, I'm gonna egg this one on. Yep, I'm gonna be buying plenty.
And just bragging, and he's saying you're not gonna let me see my kids once a week, maybe. Now you won't be spending no time with that girl, and you should just a whole lot of envious and immaturity there. And yes, so a lot of people are going through this situation. If you find the only reason to put a very responsible parent who is in the child or children's life on practically a daily basis, they're there for their children, they care for them, they provide financially as well as, you know, being a parent. And then the other parent decides to go and put that parent on child support, jeopardizing their not only their parenthood livelihood, but also possibly their freedom. So now you take a parent who was doing what they were supposed to be doing because they are responsible, now putting them in a situation to where they may have to work multiple jobs to pay the $1,200 a week. Now they may never be able to see their child or children. But if this sort of thing was strategically done and quite conniving, because if this individual is going to be working multiple jobs, it's going to take that time away from the new boo. You see what I'm saying? And it's all about that, just sheer jealousy. But at the same time, putting the children in a situation from not having bonding experiences as they grow up and creating memories with that parent. Listen, when it comes to parenting, and everyone shouldn't be one, I promise you, there are going to be certain sacrifices that one will have to make. You're going to have to put aside any childishness or animosity you have with that parent and sacrifice having both parents involved for the betterment of the child. Not down talking to your children about the other parent, none of that. And I know there are certain situations to where well, you may not be able to do that. Listen, I come from a unique situation as far as parenting, if you allow me to be candid with you. So being, you know, having a child at the age of 16, still in high school, and the father was just about to graduate, go off to his career, but he would be doing a lot of traveling, right? So one day he calls me before he gets ready to start his new endeavor. And says, look, I just came from the court. I put myself on child support so that you would always have money weekly. And I was devastated. I was so irate with him for doing that, because I would never want to have his name associated with anything court-wise. All right. I was secure with him. I believed and trusted in him, as I still do. And I didn't understand why he did that. He said, I'm going to be traveling. I'm going to be on the road. I mean, I have time to remember to send this. This was before Cash App. So, okay, it made sense to me. And as time went on, okay, he did the right thing. He handled his business. And every time he got a raise, I received a letter, hey, would you like to submit a modification to get the new amount? And that went on as the years went by. You know, it increased. He was happy. He would call practically every day and talk to us for like more than a couple hours, you know. And when he would come into town, my child was a very happy child, okay? I never talked about her father. Daddy is working, but he, you know, he bought you these, you know, new clothes, shoes, toys, all reaching up to, like, it was crazy. She had the best childhood. And when he would come into town, Daddy, look what the new Jordans you bought me, you know? It was that kind of situation. It's something we had to get used to. It wasn't the normal, usual sit down, have dinner. It wasn't that, okay? And, you know, as time went on, he ended up settling down and meeting someone. And so we still communicated. We're still friends to this day. We still communicate. Their relationship is good. And she turned out to be like the happiest child ever, because we both created a healthy family, somewhat structured abnormally, you know. Ironically, she ended up turning out to be quite like him, you know, a workaholic. And that's exactly what it was. And she understood that. As long as she knew she was being taken care of and she was loved by her parents. And see, that's the thing with children. They don't care about what is going on with that parent. The one thing that they're always going to question is, why weren't you there? Why did you neglect me? I needed hugs, not just from that parent, but from you as well. Why? And they'll be asking that even when they're at the age of 40. They go back to that childlike mindset, wanting to know why. They don't care if you were on drugs or incapable. And I get it. Some situations are far more deep than that. You may have a parent who's been charged as a sex offender. I get it. You may not want them anywhere near your child, but at the same time, you can't let them be aware of that in a negative manner. You know, you have to explain things to them to where they understand. And okay, Daddy loves you, but at the time, Daddy did some bad things and he has to pay for that. You know, you don't make it seem as like they're the worst creature in the world because you have a vendetta. That's not fair. Because what happens is when they grow older, they begin to find out what really happened and find resentment against you. And now they have two parents that are not really a part of their lives. So again, it's really a big sacrifice, not just for yourself, but for the child or the children. That's all it really is about. When you made a conscious decision to go ahead and conceive, this is what could possibly be on the other side. It's just like getting married. You don't know what that's gonna look like in 2 years, 10 years. All right. It's a sacrifice. It's taking a risk. It really is. So making the better choices, not for yourself, but for your child or your children, is always going to be precedent. It's always going to take precedence above anything else, making sure they're fed and they're taken care of. Okay. So if I could do it at such a very young age, and I would say I was quite successful. I had a lot of help, of course. So can you. You can make things work when you want it to. All right. So hopefully this video has been somewhat informative to you. Again, if you have a more unique situation and need further counseling, all of my information will be linked down below. I thank you for joining me always. That is all for now, my loves. Until next time.